Welcome tonight. We're very happy to have each and every one of you with us. It's a great day. We have a lot to be thankful for. God's been very good to us. Why don't you bow your heads with me and let's pray together. Lord Jesus, what a great, awesome God you are. We're thankful, Lord, that you are with us and that you never fail. You are the gracious and wonderful God. And here we are tonight, Lord, needing you, and we're thanking you that you're with us and that you'll never fail. I give you praise and glory in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to have a wonderful time with our Dear Gear Christmas drama tonight. I hope you're happy to be here. We're happy to have you. I don't want to put any cold water on this joyous celebration tonight, but I do have a couple of urgent prayer requests that I'd like to get you to help me pray about before we go too much further into the evening. As most of you know, little Jaslyn Jafrida. Is there any family members here tonight from Jaslyn? Okay, Jaslyn has been diagnosed with leukemia. And we're believing God that God's going to touch her and heal her. It's a very traumatic thing, however, as you can imagine. And so I have a couple urgent requests. That's the first one. I'd like to take her all by herself. Her name is Jaslyn Jafrida. She's one of the most beautiful little babies you'll ever meet. Let's pray that God would touch her and heal her. Lord Jesus, you are the great, mighty God. There's nothing too hard for you. Now, Father, I bring, and this church brings, little Jaslyn to the throne of grace right now, asking for mercy in the time of need. Lord, you said we could approach your throne. And Lord, we're coming to the throne of grace right now on behalf of little Jaslyn. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we ask for her complete and total healing, complete and total recovery. In the name of Jesus, Father, I give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Second urgent request is for Charlie Wilson. I just left the hospital to get here, and the doctors have said he's not going home. I'd like to pray that God would change that. Charlie has members, family members are here tonight, and I kind of feel like he's part of my family too. I've known him for many years, and I really love him a lot. So I'd like for God to touch him. And would you pray with me right now? Lord Jesus, again, we bring another critical need to you, Lord. God, you see Charlie Wilson, you see, Lord, right now in the hospital room here in Augusta. I pray, oh God, that you'd reach down your hand, have mercy and touch him. Lord, I thank you, Lord, that you are great and you're greatly to be praised. I ask you, Lord Jesus, that you'd touch Charlie. In Jesus' name, Lord, do a miracle there. Touch that entire family, I pray, God. In the name of Jesus, praise God. Well, a couple somber things to start out a celebration with, but we're going to have a great time, and we put all this into the hands of God. God knows what he's doing. He knew all about this before we ever did, so he knows how to help us with all these situations. And I'm sure glad that we know a God who can help and is able to do all things, nothing too hard for him. Praise God. Hey, let's lift our hands and let's give God praise. Thank you, Jesus. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Lord, you're great. You do miracles so great. There's no one else like you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. You ready? We're going to have a piano solo here. Just go ahead and play it. Jeremy's one of our dear Christian Academy students, and he's doing very well, as you can see. We're thankful for what God is doing in his life. Sister Amy, can you step out here? You can? Okay. This is our principal. We're very happy to have her with us tonight. Sarah, can you hear me? Step out here, please. This is our drama teacher, and she's doing a very good job. And do we have anything that we need to announce before we...
Brother Dina and Sister Robbie built our props, and they did an amazing job.
I'll say...
Just this week alone, over 4 hours of practice. So they're going to do awesome. Please excuse them if they yawn. We worked them very hard.
Sister Amy, does that mean it's going to last 4 hours?
If you don't listen good.
All right. Sister Sarah, do you have anything you need to tell us? Okay, you might want to grab a microphone so they can hear you. Turned on.
Good evening, everybody. So, as she said, they have worked very hard. They have been awesome with learning their lines, practicing, listening to their CDs, doing all the things that I've asked them to do, and learning to be dramatic and learning how to act and learning how to be dramatic with your voice and also, you know, with using your body and not just standing there. So you will see tonight how well they have done at learning this. So I am going to first introduce you to our cast before we begin. I will start first, actually, is not what I was going to start with. Hold on. I wrote everything down because if not, I forget. So first of all, she already mentioned the stage. However, I'm going to mention it again because this is amazing, and I was super happy when I came in to dress rehearsal on Monday. I didn't do any of this. None of this has Sarah on it at all. So Brother Dana, Sister Robbie, and then I just said in company because there was a lot of people helping to set this up. It was Brother Dana and Sister Robbie's imagination.
Have them stand up, Sister Sarah.
What?
Have them stand.
Okay, whoever. Stand up if you helped with this. How about that?
Look at this. All right.
And I know Sam's up there, and Sam helped a lot, and Katie's in there, and she helped a lot. Catherine helped, and I think she's in there as well. But anyway, many hands make light work, and they did an awesome job. So that's that, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Darius has been a huge help to me, and I would not be able to not mention him. He has not just done the sound, but he's kind of helped keep my head together while practices are going on and there's a lot of just chaotic stuff going on. But I appreciate that. And Sam as well has done a lot of running around and doing all sorts of stuff. He'll be on the lights tonight doing a fabulous job. And then Katie and Carmen have been our backstage coordinators. Can you come out, Katie and Carmen? If I dare let you both out at the same time. Thank you. They helped me by... I mean, the kids are good kids, but in the prayer room, you know, it's pretty tempting to fool around, and they've kept them very calm and quiet for me. Actually, all the teenagers have really helped out a lot. They've been very helpful, and okay, and now I'm going to present to you our cast so that we can begin our drama. We have Braxton playing the part of Mr. Carmichael. He's our toy store owner. Daniel is playing the part of Jacob. He's one of our main characters. His father owns Jesse's Trees. Juliana is playing the part of Carly. She's also one of our main characters. She also plays Mary in the pageant. Thank you. And then Cadence is playing the part of Abigail, another one of our main characters. She is running the tree lot to buy Christmas presents for needy children. We have Gabby. Gabby will be playing the part of Gwen. And then we have as well Esther, and she's playing the part of Addison, and these two run the bake sale together. Keith will be playing the part of Lucas. He's another one of our main characters, and he, and Rodney is being played by Josiah. I'm sorry, Josiah is being played. And Lucas and Rodney are two of our main characters, and they are friends with Mr. Jacob over there. And then we have, get ready, some cuteness overload. And we have three policemen during this drama, and that would be Chase, McGuire, and Jaden. And then Gabrielle is playing the part of Mom. She does a fantastic job. Tasia is a British lady, and she's also...
Hey, smile.
She's also a wise man in our nativity show, and she, or wise lady in our nativity scene. Amanda is coming, and she's playing the part of a rich lady. She's also a shepherd in the nativity scene. Aaron is playing the part of a wise man in our nativity scene. Isabella will be playing the part of a shepherd in our nativity scene. And Solomon and Jacob, they're part of our choir. And Zedric is playing the part of a customer and a wise man. Okay, so now we are ready. Just a second. Did I forget someone? Oh my goodness. Okay, I'm sorry. How did I forget my own first order? Okay, yep, I see them now. I'm sorry. I am so sorry. Okay. Elijah, how could I forget you? He's playing the part of Joseph. I'm so sorry, bud. And Olivia and Ruthie, can you turn around again? I'm sorry. Olivia and Ruthie are playing the parts of angels in our nativity scene. Sorry about that. So do we have everybody now, Katie? Okay. So we are now ready to begin our play. We present to you A Tree Lot Christmas.
T'was the week before Christmas, and all through the town, last minute shoppers were running around.
Things were too quiet at Carmichael's store. He was grumpy and greedy, for he wanted more.
So out on the lot, we were selling our trees to give him more shoppers was part of his scheme.
So come buy a tree, so we can buy toys to give to the needy and spread Christmas joy.
Welcome to Jesse's Trees, evergreens for sale. Remember, every penny we make will buy presents for our special friends.
Church bells are ringing, they're all over
about ready for tonight's celebration? Any idea how many families we're expecting?
I have no idea, but I do know we have to buy 10 more gifts for the children. We want everyone on our list to get a present tonight. Did you bring us a few more trees for us to sell?
Just a couple more. I'll go get them out of the truck. Lucas, could you give me a hand?
Sure, dude.
Jesus. out my door.
I really hope we sell enough trees to get all those gifts. Oh, I almost forgot. How's the bake sale going, girls?
It's going great. So far, we've got gluten-free,
fat-free,
sugar-free,
and peanut-free.
Sounds flavor-free to me.
Well, anyway, about 5 minutes ago, a guy said something. It was called Pay It Forward.
What does that mean?
Well, he wanted to pay for the person's food behind him as a gift, and now that's what everyone's doing.
Anybody want a sweet treat?
Are you sure you don't want to come tonight?
She's marrying the major pageant.
No, no, that magazine keeps showing up every Christmas. I can't make any money off of that. I'll get your toys.
Thank you. Merry Christmas.
I'm going back to the store. But to be politically correct, young lady, it's Happy Holidays. We don't want to offend our customers, or they won't buy from us.
Offending the customers? What about offending God?
We have to keep Christ in Christmas. After all, we're celebrating His birthday.
Walk this way.
There you are, Jacob. I was wondering where you went.
I've been tying trees to trunks. It's been a busy day.
Hey, I have a question about Christmas trees. Why do we decorate them anyway?
I can answer that one. My family's been growing evergreens for 3 generations. They're the only tree that stay green all year. It reminds me of the everlasting life we can have in Jesus.
And the tree points up to heaven. That's why we put a star on top.
And if you decorate a Jesse tree like my family does, you can hang ornaments on it that remind you of the events from creation to Christ's birth. Oh, and one more thing. I almost forgot. We hang our Jesse tree upside down.
What?
Upside down? Why would you do that?
Because it points down. Jesus came to earth for us. My dad always says that our Christmas gift from God isn't under a tree, but on a tree.
I just thought of something. Jesus paid it forward for us.
Yes, I like that. Jesus did pay it forward for us.
Hey, I know a song about a Christmas tree.
We know that one too.
Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree.
Oh, I can top that. Hit it, boys.
Like an evergreen, I'm alive in you, everlasting life, making all things new.
Like an evergreen, reaching to the sky, lifting hands in praise to my Lord on high.
Everlasting life, everlasting joy, everlasting peace, forever we'll rejoice. Everlasting love, glory to the King, I'm alive in you, like the evergreen.
Thank you.
Store.
Achoo!
There it is.
Lula, amor.
Achoo!
Any more toys?
Yes, we have just enough for the Ken and Barbie Deluxe Christmas Cottage and the Hot Wheels Racing Car. We're done.
Money, please.
Every child is getting a gift.
God gave us his only son, it makes me want to give all I can, in Jesus' name.
Mr. Carmichael here.
That would be me. What's this all about?
We're from City Hall and we're gonna shut you down.
What?
You heard me. Sir, you cannot use this area without a proper permit, and I'm afraid you do not have one.
What? I've never heard of such a thing before.
I'm sorry, we have our orders.
No!
You heard me. I have my orders.
Wait a minute. Look, I've got your permit. I pulled some strings. And here, Mr. Carmichael.
I'll be the judge of that. Okay, it's clear you're back in business.
Carmichael?
Why, yes. Why would you do something like that? Because that's what Christmas is all about. Loving one another like Jesus loved us.
Mr. Carmichael, did I mention I was playing Mary in the pageant?
You are?
Yes, Mommy. Oh, I gotta run. Wardrobe.
God so loved the world, He gave. God so loved the world, He gave. To earth for everyone. God so loved the world that He gave His only Son.
Infant holy, infant lowly, for His bed a cattle saw. Oxen lowing,
firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Suddenly an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and they were afraid.
Fear not. Fear not, the angel said to them, for I will bring you great news of great joy for all the people.
Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born.
He is Christ the Lord!
Now that was very moving. I'd like to know about this baby.
He's not a baby anymore. He's the savior of the world, and he's Lord of all.
Yes, I'd like to know more.
It's simple. God's only son, Jesus, paid for our sins with his very life. We just have to accept this free gift.
And then you get to be a part of the family of God, too.
Hey, Mr. Carmichael, you might want that Christmas tree after all.
Dude, it's a free gift.
Yeah, actually, I would. And to show my appreciation to all of you, my new family, pick out a free gift on me! Merry Christmas, everyone!
Everybody. I do have to mention one more thing. Catherine, where are you? Right here. This girl right here helped me so much. She was my co-director and she helped me with so many things and I forgot to mention her name. Thanks, everyone.
Well, I don't know about you, but I think they did a pretty great job. And there were so many parts of the drama tonight that were so relevant to our everyday lives, talking about how the whole meaning of Christmas is to love like Jesus loved and to draw others to him and point them to him. I am so thankful to be a part of the family of God. And I said this last year, and I'll say it again every chance I get. If you are not part of the family of God right now, please don't wait. join today. There's not a lot of time. We can see that in the things that are happening around us in the world. And a Christmas miracle, the miracle of salvation, can be yours today. So if you have any questions about that, I bet you any one of these kids could help you. But the rest of us would love the opportunity as well. Thank you so much for coming tonight. Our school, Brother Jafrida and I were talking about this the other day. He's pretty sure the school started in 1977, and I won't tell you the year I was born, but it's easy to remember how many years the school's been in existence after he said that. So, and Sister Soups, I think, says 79. So, Robert says 79. Okay, so somewhere in there. But we've been doing this for a long time, and I have to share something with you. The adult Christmas social for our church, our local church family, was last Saturday night, and afterwards, there was a bunch of people staying to clean up, probably 20 of them, and one person said something, and about 20 of them burst out into the school song while they were cleaning up. I'm like, oh, look, the legacy continues. McGarrett knows the school song, and he's not even in school yet. But thank you for joining us. I do have some thank yous. Brother Dana and Sister Robbie are always so willing. They never even have to be asked. They come and say, what are we doing this year for the Christmas drama? They come to help, so please come up. Some of you probably had Sister Robbie as your first grade teacher. Yes, lots of you did. And most of you have been on an adventure with Brother Dana. If you have not, ask him. He is willing. Wear your muddy shoes and pack a lunch. But it's going to be fun. All right, and the other person I wanted to make sure we said thank you tonight was to Sister Sarah. She is very much multitasking right now. She's teaching first grade for us in the morning. She's substituting for the Augusta School District in the afternoons. And she was our drama instructor this year. And she did a great job. These kids were amazing tonight. So thank you. Her very own Jesse Tree. Thank you so much for coming. God bless you, and we'll let Pastor finish.
Yes, it was awesome. Can you turn me on? Testing 1, 2, 3. Hey, there we go. Thank you. I would like to ask all those who know the school song to rise. If you don't know the school song, you don't have to rise. But if you do know the school song, all right, are you ready, children? School song, ready? Everybody, 1, 2, 3, 4. Dear Agir, Dear Agir, that's the name we like to hear as we stand up to honor our school. Here we learn to live and of ourselves to give, standing tall for Jesus every day. Take the cross with the crown, and it makes us heaven bound. Dear Agir, Dear Agir, hooray, hooray. All right. Well, the cast, if you would take one more bow, please. All rise.
All rise.
Let's take one more bow. Didn't they? They did a great job. Everybody, all right. There we go. Thank you for coming tonight. We have enjoyed this so much. Sister Amy, great job as our principal. Sister Sarah, great job as our drama teacher. And all the staff members that help make our school a great school. And all the alumni that are here tonight. And I believe it was 1979. And also, by the way, it's good to have Pastor Roix and his wife with us tonight in this drama. Have a Merry Christmas. I hope to see all of you back that can be on Sunday. We're going to have a great time, 10 a.m. and 6:30. Prayer meeting Saturday night at 6:30. And we're going to have a great week. God bless. Shake hands. Be friendly. We've already prayed tonight, so God bless you. Just shake a few hands and thank you for coming.